Water pumps pump water using electricity. And I'm going to teach you how much power it takes to do just that here in lesson number 8 of this electrical system sizing playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, the methods of estimating power that I'm going to teach you in this video will work for many different types of water pumps and sizes of freshwater tanks. So if you keep an open mind and think critically, you'll be able to apply this information to your own specific project. Last thing before we get started, I put some important information about this academy, some additional resources, and some prerequisite information related to this video down in the pinned comment below. So be sure to scroll down and check it out. Let's get started. How much power does a water pump use? The formula for daily power consumption is watts times minutes divided by 60 equals watt hours. And this SureFlow pump is pretty much the most popular one for most RVs and van conversions, so we're going to be using this as our example. It lists its power consumption as 7.5 amps at 12 volts. And to convert from amps and volts to watts, we would just multiply amps times volts, and that gives us 90 watts. Now, this water pump only uses power when it's actively flowing water, so we just need to figure out how long per day that we're using the pump. For example, it may take you 5 minutes to do your dishes after dinner, but I know whenever I'm trying to conserve water from my freshwater tank, I may be standing at the sink for 5 minutes, but I only have the water running for, like, say 30% of the time, only when I'm actively rinsing but not scrubbing. So you can really get into the nitty-gritty details there, or you can just say that the water pump is running for 5 minutes after each meal, so 15 minutes total, and then just base the calculation on that, and you'll just not use as much power in real life as you're calculating. And if you want to figure out the exact number, you can always measure with a stopwatch if you like. So 90 watts times 15 minutes divided by 60 minutes per hour gives us 22.5 watt hours. Now, in the context of an off-grid battery bank, if this power were being drawn from a 12-volt battery, 22.5 watt hours divided by 12 volts results in 1.875 amp hours, which is only 1.875% of a 100 amp hour 12 volt battery for those 15 minutes of water pump use. But before we move on, I want to hear from you. After watching this video, I would love for you to test your own water pump usage and put the results down in the comment section below. I'd like to hear what water pump you have, how many watts it uses, how long per day you're using it, what you're running water for, and how many watt hours it uses per day. I'm trying to build out a database of what kind of power usage various devices use, and teamwork makes the dream work here, so help me out and let me know down in the comment section below. Can you calculate energy consumption from gallons used? Basically, yes, it is possible to calculate energy pulled from a battery bank if you know how many gallons of water you're using. That same pump from earlier can flow 3 gallons per minute. And if we have a 30-gallon freshwater tank and our faucet doesn't have any kind of flow restrictor on it, this means that the pump would drain the tank from full to empty in 10 minutes of runtime. Now, if you had that same setup but had a 1 gallon per minute flow restrictor in your faucet, that would slow the flow of the pump and it would take 30 minutes to drain the tank. 90 watts times 30 minutes divided by 60 minutes in an hour equals 45 watt hours. So there you have it, several different methods to determine how much power a water pump uses in a mobile, marine, or off-grid electrical system. And we're going to be referring to this video later in this academy when we discuss full power audits, so be sure to bookmark it for future reference and come back to it later if you need a refresher. Now, in the next lesson, I'm going to teach you how to determine the power required for a max air vent fan. So click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.